Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This video is going to focus on the three most important settings in your privacy settings in Google. This is ideal for teachers and for students, anyone using Google. I'm going to go through these three key settings in quite a lot of detail so you really understand them and really understand what they do. Really hope the video is useful, and if it is, please like it, please share it with other teachers and students, and of course any comments, leave them in the comments section. Let's get started. So the first thing you're going to need to do is to go to your Google account. So go to google.com and then sign in to your Gmail account. That's normally the way that you access all of the different options that you've got in Google. So I'm now logged in, and I can see that because I've got that little kind of icon there. And if I click on that icon, I can go to manage your Google account. That is the one where once you're logged in, and you'll see that you've got these four blocks. In fact, there's a few more things underneath, but there's four main blocks. And now what we're going to look at first of all is this button here. Now you might get a slightly different message under here. Sometimes you get the chance to kind of do a privacy test, but don't worry about that. Click here and then just scroll down. These little suggestions will be at the top of the screen. We're not interested in those. We're interested in these key three things. So let's start with the web. Google tracks all your activity on the web. It also tracks all your activity on other devices that Google uses. For example, Google Maps, when you're working on Google Drive, etc. But it also tracks any activity you do on devices that are connected. We often connect applications to Google, and it also tracks those. So let me take you through how you control what Google tracks of your activity. First of all, this shows you exactly what Google is tracking. Okay, and the first thing is that it's tracking your web activity. In other words, when you search on the internet, it's keeping a record of those sites for you. Okay, now why is that useful? Well, it's very useful if you go back. It will help you to do a search a lot quicker. If you come in again and try to search for that same website, it obviously stores in that in the history. You can therefore go back and find it in the history. You may want to turn this off. Let's imagine that we want to turn off web activity. So we don't want Google to follow the websites that we search for, etc. So we're going to click on turned on. We're going to click here. Okay, in fact, you can, just click here. And you do have the option, if you wanted to, to actually turn that off. So that is where you would do that, okay? That's one really important thing to know. Now I'm going to show you a couple of other things that you can do regarding tracking your visits on the internet. So notice that you can turn this button off here, okay? And if you do that, what it basically means is that other devices that are kind of connected to your Google services are also tracking your activity. That would be when you're using Google Chrome or when you're using other apps within the Google Suite. So things like Google Drive, when you're using perhaps Google Jamboard, when you're using perhaps your Google Maps, etc. Okay, and even other devices that are connected to YouTube. For example, when you log in to an account to another device using your Google account to log in, which is something we can do, then also in that case, it will be tracking your activity. You can also set auto delete. So if I click here, then I can automatically have content, my searches, deleted after a certain amount of time. At the moment, I don't auto delete my activity, but I could do that. I could click here and even set a period of time and say, right, every 3 months, I want all my content auto deleted. Okay, that's a useful option. I'm going to close that. I'm going to come down to another interesting one here, manage activity. Now I'm going to click here. Why would you want to manage activity? Well, one thing is that you may want to actually delete the fact that Google has got the history of websites that you've already visited in the past, and you might decide that you want to delete that. So if you notice here, you can actually see what you've been doing today or what you've been doing other days, what you've been searching on the internet for, okay? It will show you all your activity. Now, if you click here, notice that you can delete activity by, okay? And you can click here and you could, for example, delete web and app activity. And I'm going to click here and choose all time, okay? And I can select all, I can say, so I've got all of this activity that's taking place on all these devices that are connected to my account, including, of course, searching on Google. I can click on next, okay? And then I can delete all of these, okay, which is what I'm going to do, just to show you how that works, just to show you that you can actually, if you want to delete all your activity, then it is possible to do that. Now if I close that down now, okay, click on close that down, you'll notice hopefully that now there isn't anything showing because all my activity has been deleted. Just a really quick break just to promote the fact, if you like the video that you're watching and you want more videos about digital skills for teachers and students, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com, and on the opening page you've got a special section, and if you click on it, called Digital Skills Training in Digital Literacies for Teachers and Students, and you've got here a whole range of different videos to help you with different areas that are relevant both to teaching and to students as well. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated on all the latest videos, the blogs, the webinars, as well as the online courses that I run. Thanks ever so much. Let's get back now to the video. Now we're going to take a quick look at location history. Google can track your movements. In other words, if you make use of Google Maps, then you need to have location activity. And it's also good if you want to track where your devices are. So that can be a useful security issue. And it might be something that you're interested in, just simply keeping a record of where you're traveling around. So let's just look at a couple of the options when it comes to location. Whenever you're on a particular page, you can always click up here and then click on manage your account to bring you back, yeah, to that opening page, because I want to just quickly get back to the opening page. Sometimes you can do it from here as well. You'll see in a minute a couple of times when you can do it from here. It allows you to jump straight back. But if I click here, I come straight back to that page. And again, we're focusing on this area, okay, the privacy settings, which is absolutely vital that we understand these both as a teacher and as a student. And so far what we've done is we've looked in detail at that first one. Now let's just jump over to the location history. Now in my case I've got this pause, but if I click here, if I do want to turn on the location history, then I do it here. Now why would you do the turn on the location history? Well, there are a number of reasons, but one of the most obvious ones is if you use Google Maps. So for example, when you're traveling around, if you want recommendations about local restaurants, if you're using Google Maps even to travel from one location to the other, then you do need to have your location history on, and it will provide you with additional information. So I don't have the location history on this particular device, but you can just turn it on by clicking on that button. And again, you can manage your activity from this button here. Finally, we're going to look at the YouTube history. Every time you watch a video, that can be tracked. It can be useful because you can actually go onto YouTube and go to the history and find a video that you were watching 2 or 3 weeks ago, which is one of the reasons I leave it on. It also helps me because it means that Google knows the types of videos I like watching, and I find that useful. You may want to turn it off, or you may want to delete your history. I'm going to show you both. Let's look at that now. Now, I've got my YouTube history turned on, and the reason for that is that it simply knows more about who I am, what I like watching, and it means therefore that if I click on YouTube, it will make suggestions based on the information that it's got. Again, though, if we click on this button, it is possible for us to turn that off, okay? And that will obviously influence the types of videos that are shown to you on the screen. And very similar to when we look on the internet and we're controlling the kind of internet browsing, etc. If we click on auto delete here, we do have the option of, after a certain amount of time, deleting that activity. I haven't got that set. And exactly the same, we can click on manage activity as well and begin to control the videos that we want to delete. So let's have a quick look now then at how you can manage your activity on YouTube. So we click here. And you'll notice we kind of had similar things. We've got a record here of videos we've been visiting on YouTube. And we can also come up to here. This is quite a useful button. And remember, we can delete activity. Okay. And then we can delete activity all of all time, last day, last hour, or even set a custom range. That is a really important set of settings, really worth teachers knowing about them, really worth students knowing about them. Great to pass that knowledge on to students. It gives them much more control of their devices. So really hope that video was useful. As I said before, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. You can find out about my new courses that I'm running. You can also get to these free sections here, as well as all these free technologies that I deal with here at the top. And if you want to sign up to my newsletter, you can keep up with all the latest videos, the latest blogs, the latest webinars, as well as the online courses that I run. And of course, you can sign up to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell if you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And finally, if you wanted to contact me about doing any training with your organization, either online or in person, then you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much.